This Woodwork is sponsored by
Microjig, maker of the Gripper. Work safer, work smarter.
Back when I posted my workbench build video just over a year ago, there were some people asking me to do another video where I demonstrated how I made my bench dogs. And so, as well as showing you how I made my original bench dog and a few other different styles of bench dogs, I'm also going to be doing one with limited tools. Buying bench dogs commercially is surprisingly expensive, so it definitely makes good sense to be making these yourself. These are the two bench dogs which I made when I first built this workbench. They're pretty much the same as each other. This one's a little bit better as it was the second one that I did. This one's just a bit too loose in the hole, so I had to stick some electrical tape on it to get a tight enough fit. So I think we should just jump right in and I'll demonstrate how I made these little bench dogs on the lathe. I'm using a parting tool to establish the diameter of the bench dog, which is going to be 19mm or 3/4 of an inch. At this point I'll leave it slightly oversized to leave myself some room for sanding. I thought I would experiment a little bit with this new bench dog, and so I'm turning a few grooves along its length to see if that helps with grip and setting the height of the bench dog. Now I'll quickly take the bench dog off the lathe to test the fit. This one appears to be okay, but if it was a bit too tight, you just need to sand it a little bit more. And to finish it off, I'm sanding a flat onto the head of the bench dog. I haven't actually applied any finish to this bench dog yet, but it might be a good idea to do that yourself. Just make sure that you factor in a little bit of room for the thickness of the finish. With your bench dog made, it has a number of uses. You can set it to the height which you need, and then you can butt a piece of stock up against it. Potentially you might be using a hand plane or something, and you'll be able to run the plane in that direction and it shouldn't go anywhere. Or alternatively, you might want to clamp something into place while you're working on it, and so with two bench dogs set up, you can just clamp that down into place and that really doesn't go anywhere. The advantage of having both the flat face and leaving the curved surface at the top here is that, of course, as I demonstrated, you can use the flat face to butt a straight piece of stock up against it. But if you have a curved board or something, you can use the rounded surface instead. And with that, you run less risk of denting the surface of that piece or the edge of that piece than you would if you had the flat face. I realise not all of you will have access to a lathe, so I thought I would make one last bench dog like this one that I've turned by hand.
And there we go, there's a round bench dog made without using the lathe. The advantage of these style of bench dogs is that you can store them actually in the surface of the bench ready to use. I've made them slightly longer than the thickness of the workbench so that I can just reach underneath and push it up. And a nice way of storing these other bench dogs is just to stick them in the underside of the vise. I hope this has helped some of you guys out, and if not anything else, saved you a little bit of money. I hope you'll take the time to like, comment, share and subscribe before you leave. Thank you very much for watching, everyone, and I hope to see you again really soon. Take care for now. Bye bye.